anything around you that can happen that God won't show you. The Bible said the Holy Ghost, it'll show you things to come. It'll reprove the world of sin, righteousness, and judgment. Hallelujah. And I said all that, I guess, to say this. You know, they done got that thousands of people in America done took that old chip. And Brother Terrell, the prophet, said in the ministers meeting, those that done took it, it's, and if you don't believe it, go to your Bible and read Revelations. That chip. That mark. You need to be praying every day, God, don't let none of my loved ones. But, you know, I got hundreds of family back down in Florida, and I pray all the time, Lord. You know, they don't even know God. And that thing, it's getting serious, folks. We're getting close to the end of time. And that old homosexual spirit, man, it's strong out there. My nephew had a motorcycle accident a few months back. They called me and my wife. And I heard about it, but I guess I ain't never really seen it. I know I'm behind times. And we went and prayed for him, and there was a mall right across the street. And we walked in the mall, my wife owned a little Body Works, something, you know, you women like smell good. Us men, we don't care, you know. But anyway, we went in there and picked it up while I was there. I noticed this other guy. They were standing beside each other. This other picked up some stuff and was rubbing him on the back of the head, you know, like that. And I thought, that don't look right. So we walked out of there and looked over, and there's a coffee shop right there. I told my wife, I found out some stuff this last day or two about that place. I said, I'm going to go over and get me a winning coffee thing. And we walked out, and them boys was following us. They must have been, that mall was packed out. They must have been just right there where we was, 100, 200 people just standing, you know, just packed out. And before the Lord in heaven, them two boys walked up there. And it wasn't no just little smack. When I saw that ice cream, oh my God, what's going on? Look at that. I don't know if it embarrassed or not, but man, everybody in that, within 20, 30 feet was watching them boys, hallelujah, put their lips together and give one another a smack. And you know what they done when they got through? They looked at me and like, you stupid idiot. So bad it's getting out there, folks. Every day, you need to be praying. God, don't let this old Bible says it was in the days of Sodom, as it was in the day. You need to be praying. God, don't let that spirit jump off on my kids. I got a nephew right now, lives in Florida, that has openly confessed on his cell phone he's a homosexual. Broke my heart. I pray for him all the time. God, get that spirit off of him. My nephew's son, actually. I don't know if it'd be what kin that is. I guess it's still my nephew, ain't it? My nephew's son, about, what, 16, 17 years old. John openly confesses, he's gay. Hallelujah, folks, has there been a time we need to be praying for our kids, grand, youngins, nephews, and nieces, aunts, uncles, and everybody, that God don't let this chip or this old homosexual spirit get on them? It's now. It's now. Now, I just want us to take out a minute here and just raise our hands and ask God, Lord, right now, God, there's a lot to pray about, Lord. God, but Lord, I pray right now, Jesus, that you won't let this old, Lord, chip. Don't let none of my loved ones. Lord, I'd rather you just take me to heaven than have to see one of my boys or my daughter take it. Oh, God. Lord, don't let none of my kinfolks, my nephews, my nieces, and Lord, none of my loved ones, Lord. I asked my daddy the other day, Lord, what would he do if they told him he's going to cut his Social Security check out? He said, I guess they just have to take it. Make me feel so good, Lord. God, but it's coming down to it. We ain't going to be able to buy or sell. God, that old chip, they done put it in the cards. Lord, it's just a matter of time. Oh, God. Lord, they're going to put it, oh, God, in our hand, our forehead. God, but don't let nobody here do it. Don't let none of their kinfolk do it. Protect them from it. Lord, you will provide. Lord, you will provide. Oh, God, don't let this old homeless sexual spirit get on them. Lord, I asked it. God, on none of their loved ones. God, because, Lord, this is one spirit you can't make it to heaven with. Jesus' name. And you know, I was telling about my boy. And I saw him. And he was, and when I saw him, I said, son, you can't take that chip because you'll go to hell. And he looked at me and said, Daddy, what am I going to do? How am I going to feed my family? And a voice come out of my chest and said, God will provide. Amen. I'm telling you right now, if God don't provide for us, he's going to call Moses out of the wherever he's at, and all them 3.5 million people, and he's going to have to repent. Because if he can feed them for 40 years, manna, hallelujah, can't take care of us for 3.5 years, hallelujah, I ain't serving an unjust God. I'm serving a just God. How many of y'all serving a just God? Hallelujah. I'm telling you right now, God's going to take care of you. Don't you let him. How many of you remember about been 18, 20 years ago right up here in this city? Brother Terrell had his tent up, and we had Brother Carl Sanders come in. Was anybody in that meeting? Some of y'all was there. How many remember Brother Carl Sanders? He was a man that worked for the government. Invented a computer chip. It's got a lithium battery in it. And I've become pretty good friends with him. We had him come different places. Had him come right up here, but had a tent. And he invented that computer chip. And it's got a lithium battery, and it has to have a temperature. And the only two places in the body that it will work is either your forehead or your hand. See, God knows all this 2,000 years ago when he showed it to John. How many of you know that? Hallelujah. And God told him, said, I want you to get out of government. You know, they tried to kill him, but they ain't been able to do it. I haven't heard from him now about a year. I hope he's still alive. But he said, I want you to go around the country warning people. And that's what his life's all about. And said, tell them that don't take the chip. And before you go on, it's already going to be out there. Hallelujah. If he's going on now, that thing's already out there, folks. It ain't mandatory right now. It's you can accept it. But one day it's going to be you just ain't going to be able to buy or sell without it. I'm telling you right now, I hope I get to see you before it happens. But don't take that chip in your hand or your forehead. Because if you do, one day you'll wake up in hell. It ain't nothing spiritual about it. I don't care what nobody says. This thing is serious, folks. But don't you worry about it. God's going to take care of you. God's going to provide for you. If he has to rain manna out of heaven, has to bring quail down, hallelujah, God. Let somebody stand up. Let Brother Groover stand up with a stick, hit a rock, water come out of it. We everybody God going to take care of it. Hallelujah. God will provide. If you get that oil cruise, Brother Groover, look up back here. Hallelujah. Pray for her this evening. How many of you love the Lord? Yes. Well, I appreciate it. Good to see this young man again. Hallelujah. Good to see you, brother. Good to see you. I'm hanging in there. Pray for us too. We stay out here. Trying to get, how you doing, bro? Good to see you. Thank you, Lord. Stretch your hand this way. Lord, right now, God, we ask you. God, she needs a touch. Lord, ain't feeling too good. God, but right now, we change all this. God, you bore pain 2,000 years ago. Lord, and right now, Lord, I command all this pain to go. Come out of this body, Lord. Leave it, Father. You do that work in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, it's done. Amen. Don't you love it? Honey, well, we had it.